It's been just 1 week since a Democratic convention ended, and Hillary Clinton has surged to big leads over Republican Donald Trump in virtually every national poll. Today, new numbers put her ahead by as much as 15 points and found her trying to win over doubters.
Hillary Clinton ended the week on a high note, but she acknowledged today that many voters say they still don't trust her. She spoke to black and Hispanic journalists in Washington.
You know, it doesn't make me feel good when people say those things, and I recognize that I have work to do. I'm going to work my heart out in this campaign and as president to produce results for people.
At the same time, Clinton secured a major endorsement from former acting CIA director Mike Morell. He wrote in the New York Times that Donald Trump has no experience in national security, and worse yet, quote, the character traits he has exhibited during the primary season suggest he would be a poor, even dangerous, commander-in-chief. Morell said Trump's praise of Russian President Vladimir Putin suggests he's become a, quote, unwitting agent of the Russians. But on NBC this morning, Republican vice presidential nominee Mike Pence dismissed the Morell endorsement.
And truthfully, honestly, the comment by the former CIA official, like, I suppose this is the same CIA that told the president that ISIS was the JV team.
The back and forth came as Trump admitted he had been mistaken in saying that he had seen video of Iranians unloading a U.S. cash payment this year, around the same time four Americans were freed from Iranian prisons. Today, Trump tweeted, the plane I saw on television was the hostage plane in Geneva, Switzerland, not the plane carrying $400 million in cash going to Iran. Later, Trump and Pence linked up in Des Moines, Iowa, as they worked to rally the heartland against Clinton.
If Hillary Clinton becomes president, you will have terrorism, you will have problems, you will have, really, in my opinion, the destruction of this country from within.
Trump also holds a rally in Green Bay, Wisconsin this evening, amid reports he is about to reverse himself and endorse House Speaker Paul Ryan in his primary election after all. But intra-party divisions will still be on display, with Wisconsin's top Republican officials, Ryan, U.S. Senator Ron Johnson, and Governor Scott Walker, all planning to be somewhere else instead.